The Kundalini symbolizes the raw, primal, unreserved potential of humanity's true condition, the truest nature of humanity, either refined or in its most gross expression. This energy center sits at the base of the human body, which is ruled over esoterically by the mystical sign of Scorpio.
This chakra is what we refer to as the Muladhara chakra, which sits as the very power center or the power soul of all the chakras. This is why it centers itself right at the base, at the root, and why it is referred to as the root chakra. It is this root chakra which all the chakras use the energy from once that root chakra is able to find its way through the other chakras and open up the petals around those chakras, thus enhancing and finding different expressions for this cosmic, sexual, and most creative energy.
The Swiss psychiatrist and psychoanalyst Carl Jung once remarked, "The serpent owes his existence to God, and by no means to man." But what happens if man becomes God? Then surely the serpent serves the divine man. In Scorpio, we see this lesson, the lesson of the disciple finally overcoming their beastly instincts and mounting the fixed cross.
The fixed cross in esoteric astrology refers to all of humanity's basic instinctual actions. These are the actions that basically propel humanity throughout life. These are the things that we find necessary, however, in many ways, based on how society now drums things up, we have corrupted these very instinctual patterns within us. And this is why the fixed cross is linked to the predominance of all the fixed signs in the natal birth chart in esoteric astrology. These fixed signs all tell a story of the disciple or the individual learning to deal with the demands of the instinctual influences of these signs, thus learning how to progress from those signs.
The initial reaction to a Kundalini awakening has been known to instill a sense of fear and dread, as the ego is forced to recondition itself in the face of ultimate cosmic truth. Should the ego survive this apocalyptic reveal and open up a point in which this raw cosmic energy can synchronize with the host, a new all-encompassing power that has been repressed for millennia becomes available to the reconstructed divine ego. And suddenly, the individual sips from the whole and becomes a living symbol for this cosmic energy. The individual who becomes aware and can safely use this energy becomes a node in which other seekers can learn from. But because this energy is rather yin in nature, women who more than often exhibit this feminine energy find it easier to sync with this forceful cosmic power. However, that's not to say men cannot, but they must be taught. During the pre-Hermetic period, selected women took the role of the tutor and spoke before men, not after them. Once they themselves were able to form a beneficial union with their own Kundalini power and learn the sacred rituals and teachings of how to teach those who sought out a similar understanding. The archetype of Mary Magdalene is an example of the sacred priestess who taught the sacred science of self-knowledge and control of one's own Kundalini to Jesus Christ himself. And together, both of them discovered their own twin gnosis.
An interesting fact that you will continuously be confronted with whenever you Google in particular or look up the pictures of Jesus and Mary Magdalene together, Mary Magdalene always seems to be depicted in this almost submissive role in which she's trying to plead with Jesus Christ not to go and basically get himself crucified. But the way I like to see it is basically going back to a conversation I had a while back with one of my teachers. And this teacher said to me that they don't try and lecture people from a stance of superiority. What they always try to do is try and lift their disciples up. So, fellow alchemists, I hope you really enjoyed that very short take on the power of the Kundalini and its dormancy in us all, and also how women played a huge role in helping us come into a better union with this type of very powerful cosmic yin-style energy that lives within us all and that is present within us all and that can be used within us all. So if you really did enjoy this little short video, please don't forget to subscribe, drop a like down below, go into the comment section down below, tell us what you thought of the video, tell us if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next one when I decide to do something worthwhile. So until then, take very good care of yourself. Goodbye.